What does everybody feel like doing? Do we want to do another rehearsal of the new one?
I first heard of Coheed and Cambria, or took notice of them, when they had a unicorn in their video.
Hey Claudio, would you prefer to record another and then sing, or do each one as we go?
I'm Joe Barisi. What else do you want to know? I recorded and mixed with Atticus and co-produced. Split it down the middle, man.
We knew both of their bodies of work, you know, with either Barisi doing, like, you know, with some of the Tool records and Queens records, and, you know, Atticus did with Teeth and, you know, Year Zero, and, you know, like, that's pretty heavyweight, you know, that's pretty heavy stuff.
I mean, normally I produce and record stuff myself, but with Atticus, it seemed like a perfect marriage. Together, it seems kind of cool because he lets me do what I need to do and I let him do what he needs to do, and it is fairly seamless.
We did the album in two chunks of time. One was coming into the summer, we did six tracks and mixed those, and then we came back here about 4 or 5 weeks ago. This is December we're in now, and we're getting into the last three mixes of a total of 12 tracks.
You know, writing just riffs on my own or whatever, I always find that, you know, melodies just kind of come out. It's just, you know, it's just kind of habit. It's how I learned how to play guitar, you know, singing and playing. And it just happens. And if the melody is strong enough, you tend to, you know, give it a second look. Wait a second, this riff can do something.
Check. I'm giving up the one I love.
Certainly in a band that has like this concept behind it, I mean, the first thing to think, you know, I think an outsider would think is that, you know, story first. But it's not for me. It's really, you know, I, as much as there is this fiction, it's, you know, a lot of this stuff is very real.
How can Doc the Great Disaster to scar my skin to own this hurt?
The fantasy part comes last, you know. It's really, you know, kind of what, you know, what I'm going through is what comes first.
You're singing great.
Oh, thanks.
That's amazing.
We were talking yesterday a little bit about Here We Are Juggernaut, and you know, again, it's very much about my relationship with my wife. You know, we've been seeing each other for about 7 years, and you know, like any relationship, they have their ups and downs. You know, we've been engaged for a year or so. She, you know, she decided she was gonna take a trip to a remote island in the Bahamas for a wedding, which had no cell phone reception. We barely talked for that week, and I got to thinking about everything and just like all we had gone through in these 7 years and how strong of a team we've become. And you know, all the bullshit aside, I mean, here we are, Juggernaut. You know, this one unit. You know, just pushing forward and. You know, it's a very special tune for me.
World of Lines is very much about being misunderstood by press. Comic books are to most people that don't really understand them, are a childish medium. And we are a band that has a concept behind it that lives in that medium a little bit. And sometimes I can't help but feel like, you know, reviewers don't necessarily listen to the records. They just immediately know what's kind of tagged with the band, and therefore, you know, it's not, this music isn't meaningful. This music is childish, and let's throw it to the wayside.
Leave us alone if it's not worth the living.
You know, Travis is a great songwriter. I'll come to Travis and I'll say, hey, I have this melody that I think is suitable for this song.
I'm a guitar player in a band that consists of two guitar players, and one of them being, you know, the primary songwriter. So it's like, you know, to add to that and to, you know, and for us to play off each other the way that we do. Obviously times where it can get rough with certain things, like, you know, with trying to figure out what sounds right and being stuck on a part that, you know, won't exactly work.
Maybe just something like finger picky that goes along with it.
But the fact is, you know, we've done it so many years that it always seems to work itself out.
One sits in better. Yeah. And I didn't pick it all.
But you know this line, like coming into the third chorus, what would it be like if it was like you were playing it like, so you were picking that fast?
These guys, though, are great musicians, really great musicians, to the point where they could play a track and then decide, well, you know, the sound isn't quite right. Can you do it again? Sure, no problem. And they'll do it again. It's like a pleasure at that point because you're not really a slave to a computer and trying to fix stuff. You're really just, it's all up to performance at that point.
For sitting with Atticus and Joe and having them just plug me in and have this certain sound, you know, it could be effects or it could just be the certain guitar that I'm using to have a different sound, and new things will come out of that, and they make great additions to the song.